economic reasons. Have you came across any developments, if any, please elaborate.
Very good question, but let me share with you. When you provide food, or you provide clothing, or you provide a house, you're providing a shelter. So, if you do any side of a house, what's the first thing that you must think of? I want to provide a house which is of quality. It doesn't matter what sector of economy do we do, whether it's an affordable housing plot or it's a super luxurious bungalow that you prepare. The objective should be to make a great house. Within budget, different segments of it should be done. So, when we made buildings for affordable housing segments, those buildings now are 25 years old, but not one of them required repair because of the quality of work that they have. Yes, the amenities may be lower in terms of the affordable housing segment. You don't have a marble, you have the other tiles which are normal and other things which are not expensive. But the core of the whole product has to be a quality which works. It doesn't matter what the issue is. What is missing in our country is the fact that you don't give quality in terms of the product that you deliver. But fortunately, things have changed. With the change in the economy, when you get a phone, whether you get a 1 lakh phone or you get a 2000 rupee ordinary Nokia phone that is there, both the phones are able to connect in terms of speech. You may not be able to do the rest of it. What we really need to do is to see that every segment of the economy functions like that. And we really need to move that way. In our country, we have worked on the chalta hai attitude of the whole matter. And I think that chalta hai attitude has to go. We have to see that everything is the best. There is corruption in India and corruption in Dubai. There's a contractor in Dubai who made a bad road. He had paid money to one of the persons in ministry to take the contract of that road in Dubai. But he made a bad road and he was arrested because he made a bad road. And he went to the person to whom he had paid money for the contract, for taking the contract. And the person said, he asked that person, please help me. I did a bad job. I'm sorry. I won't do it again. Please help me. He said, in my country, you can't make a bad road. I gave you corruption money for doing the contract, but I can't make a bad road. My country, Dubai, cannot have a bad road. That is the integrity of the people of that country must come out. This is the integrity which is missing. You cannot make a bad anything. So if you are a doctor, you must be a good doctor. If you are an engineer, you must be a good engineer. If you are a physicist, you must be a great physicist. If you are a good MBA, you must be a great MBA. All the factors that you need to do is to do it, and there must be integrity and honesty with what you do. That is missing. And we need to cover that up very, very quickly. If you don't, the country can never progress to the extent and speed that we need it to do. We need to do it. When they say Swachh Bharat, it means seriously that each one of us must participate in that. And when everybody participates, the country will definitely be clean. You go to Japan, and if somebody sees something which is dropped on the streets, they will pick it up, thinking that the person who has dropped it is not dropped it intentionally. He's dropped it by mistake, and since the road is dirty, the person who sees it will pick it up and clean, see that the street is clean. Here we will throw the
pig on the street. What is important is to see that the ethical values that you have in terms of it have to be owed not only to yourself or your immediate family, but it has, or to your own house. It has to be to your building, to your area, to your city, to your country. In every possible way, we need to be ethical and correct. The day we learn to make that change to happen, and it's not difficult to do, world over, people are doing it. We need to have a change in attitude. It can happen, and there is no reason why it can't happen in this country. I'm sure that it will happen one day. We need to make a declaration right from the highest level. We have done so many declarations. This is one thing which we really need to do. And we have to be proud that we make the best building, we make the best roads, we make the best everything that is there in the country.
when my engineers go abroad or the workers go abroad in the construction industry, the same worker does a better job in Dubai because the discipline there is better. So we need to bring in that innate discipline into the country in order to do it. But it depends on each and every one of us. If we all are disciplined, people around us will become more and more disciplined. So it's not about the leader of the game alone. It's about each and every one of us which really carries this thing. Once we do that, country will change and we will be more proud of our country than we are today. There is a lot of great things that I can talk about and a lot of fun things we can talk about. I went to Egypt. First thing they asked me, you've come from country of Shah Rukh Khan and Amitabh Bachchan, Bollywood of the world. So we excel at so many things. As I told you about engineers, doctors in America, they're proud of the fact that Indians are good doctors and engineers. And those who go to the Indian doctors refuse to go to the American doctors because the Indian doctor is better. So that's the kind of pride we should have, and that we have to be the best. And it should come from within by habit, rather than to say that you do it or I do it.
One question for you. You've talked about how students should focus on utilizing their intellectual resources so as to contribute toward the development of the country. And I totally agree with that. But don't you think that by emphasizing on increasing the output that students gain from their education, we might end up escalating the mental pressure that already envelops the student lives in India?
You can never be over-educated. You can have only excess information. Information is always in excess, whether in your brain or otherwise. And if you don't have excess information, please go to Google. So, don't compare education and knowledge for information. So your brain can be overfull with information, overfull with things, and you can have a lot of education. But you have to understand, to be educated in terms of knowledge and wisdom is never enough. For God's sake, please don't stop learning. All your life, don't stop learning. Let me tell you a short story. My father was a doctor at age 82. We used to have morning meetings, and I used to chat with him over a cup of tea. And when I chatted with him one day when he was 82 years of age, he said, I want to go to Germany to learn an operation. He was an ENT surgeon. So I said, Dad, you're 82. So he said, I'm only 82. Then I told him, why do you want to go to Plester and learn a new operation? He said, because I want to know something new. I want to be educated and learn something new. So I said, who's this doctor? So he said, Dr. Plester. I said, isn't he the same doctor who came to learn an operation from you 10 years ago, of an operation which you had devised? So he said, yes, the same person has now created a new operation of the mastoid area, which I want to go and learn. So my father went at age 82 to Germany to learn an operation from Professor Plester in Germany, who was one day, 10 years before, came to India to learn an operation from him. So learning and education is perennial. You can't stop learning. But information can be a surfeit. I have a huge amount of information lying in my inbox, in my mailbox, in my thing, into the Facebook, into whatever, Instagram, everywhere. But that's not knowledge and wisdom that we have to have, which we need for the purposes of it. So the world will deluge you with information and other aspects and movies and films and pornography and you name it, everything is available for you to imbibe. But don't stop learning. And if you stop learning, you're as good as dead. So if you want to die early, stop learning today. So don't stop learning all your life. Whatever be your age, please continue to learn. And there is no excess of learning. There is no excess of being educated. But yes, there can be a surfeit of education, information, which you have to put aside the clutter, move it on one side, forget it, eliminate it, put it into the
trash box of your mind and otherwise, and you'll be a perfectly great guy. But not to stop learning, not to stop being educated all your lives. Till the day you're dying, one day before that, please learn something.